Chris Philip is a world authority on things that go whiz, bang and whoopee on bonfire night. His collection of books and prints on the subject goes back to the 16th century, when following in the tracks of the Chinese 1,000 years earlier, the Western world realised that gunpowder could be fun. Pyrotechnia, or a discourse of artificial fireworks, was published in 1635, and it's still relevant.
And many of the items in this picture would be recognisable to anybody today, and a 16th century pyrotechnist coming to a site today would see the same things. He'd see the rockets, the shells, the line rockets, the set pieces and wheels. Very little has changed in the basic type of firework that is used. The colours and effects have got much better, but the basic items have remained the same.
Chris's own company lights the blue touch paper at everything from rock concerts to displays mounted on national holidays in the Arab world, and he reckons you can't beat the professionals.
Father always likes lighting fireworks in the back garden, but obviously if you go to a display, you'll get far better value for money, and you'll see several thousand pounds worth of fireworks fired for only the cost of a pound or so.
And I suppose there's the safety aspect as well.
And indeed a well-organised public display is obviously much safer than the hazards that can occur if people fool about with fireworks at home. The rule is follow the firework code.